Here we go for the next problem. 1 plus sec a by sec a is equal to sin square a by 1 minus cos a. So here it is given, simplify LHS and the RHS separately. I think if we simplify the LHS, we will be getting one term. So that's why we have to simplify separately. Let's see. So LHS is 1 plus sec a by sec a, right? So this we can simplify. We need RHS, you can see, in terms of sine and cos. So let me change according to that. So sec, let me write in terms of cos, write in a 1 by cos a, right? So, divided by here sec, also we can write as a 1 by cos a. So now we can take an LCM. So it will become an cos a plus 1 divided by cos a, the whole divided by 1 by cos a. So cos a get cancelled. And we will be getting an cos a plus 1 divided by 1, which is equal to cos a. So we get simplified, and we cannot simplify more. And but RHS, you can say it is in the types of an fractions, right? So let me choose the RHS and we'll simplify. We'll get the same, I think. This is one of the method to prove both RHS equal to LHS. So sin square a divided by, I was writing here, 1 minus cos a. I hope you can see now. So this we are going to apply it. So for this LHS we got everything in the cos. So let me change this sine square into the cos by the identities. We know that it is a 1 minus cos square a divided by 1 minus cos, and it is easy. We already done. Just we can giving apply the 1 as in 1 square. So a square minus b square formula, we will get a plus b and a minus b. So that minus term and this minus term will get cancelled, right? So 1 square minus cos square a divided by 1 minus cos a. Since I'm writing this to cancel the denominator, we will get sure without square we will be getting. It's a square, right? So a square minus b square formula, we will be getting identities, we will be getting a plus b into a minus b. That's a square neglected, so the denominator will be get cancelled. So 1 plus cos a into 1 minus cos a divided by 1 minus cos a. So you can notice that 1 minus cos a and 1 minus cos a get cancelled, and we get a 1 plus cos a. Same we got in the LHS. So therefore LHS is equal to RHS. Hence we have proved. So here we go for the next problem. Cos a minus sin a plus 1 by cos a plus sin a minus 1 is equal to cosec a plus cot a, using the identity cosecant square a plus 1 plus cot square a. So they give a hint to use this also. So let me see. So let me choose the first LHS. We will be getting in a cos a minus sin a plus 1 divided by cos a plus sin a minus 1. So let me change this to cosecant and cot, since they said to use that by dividing. See here the cos a, if we get cos by sine, we will be getting a cot, right? The same way if we divide a sine here, we will be getting an cosec. 1 by sine is a cosec, right? So let me divide sine a on both numerator and denominator, right? Since we are doing this to get in terms of a cosec and cot, so cos we will be getting as a cos a by sin a, right? So it will become a cot, right? So that's why. So sin a by sin a, the second term, and third term is a 1, so 1 by sin a. This whole is divided by cos a by sin a plus sin a by sin a minus 1 by sin a. So this will cancel 1, and this cancel 1. So rest we get in the terms of cot and cosec. So we have to think in that to change the given into terms of the cosec and cot. If you divide by the sin equally, everything we will be getting, right? So cos by sin we get as an cot a. And minus 1 here is a plus 1 by sin a, we can write as a cosec a divided by cos by sin, the same cot a, but here is a plus 1 minus cosec a. Clear? So now, since they said to apply this, if you represent in terms of 1, it will become an cosecant square a minus cot square a, right? So instead of this 1 and that 1, let me apply this. So I hope we will be getting it. Let's check. So it will be the cot a minus, instead of 1, we are going to substitute this cosecant a minus plus minus cot a. While bringing this side, it will become a cot a, right? We'll be getting it as an cosecant square a minus cot square a is equal to 1, right? So instead of 1, we are going to substitute here cosecant square a minus cot square a. The rest is a plus cosecant a divided by same. We are going to apply here cot a plus cosecant square a minus cot square a. Instead of 1, so the rest is a cosecant. Clear? So let me open this bracket, multiply here, we will be getting as an cot a minus cosecant square a plus cot square a plus cosecant a divided by cot a plus cosecant square a minus cot square a, it's a minus cosecant a. Right, just I am minus I multiplied here and plus I multiplied here and I have written these things here. Right, so let me bring this to the non-square terms here and you can see that this is an a square minus b square form, right? Just by rearranging you will be getting an a square minus b square. Let me give a clear picture about it. Cot a, let me bring this, just I am rewriting the order just to show the make it easy to show you. So now we can see, right, it's a non-square terms are here, it is like an a square minus b square, and you can see here we got it as an cosecant square a minus cot square a. Okay, let it be that. So this non-square also let me bring here. So that it will become an cot a is equal to minus cosec a plus cosecant square a minus cot square a. So I think we are not going to disturb this. Let me only change this to a square minus b square form. So we will getting a common term outside, I hope. So cot a plus cosec a, so a square minus b square, we can write it as an a plus b and a minus b, right? Cot a plus cosec a into cot a minus cosec a. So divided by cot a minus cosec a plus cosecant square a minus cot square a. So here you can see that here cot a plus cosecant a is there, here is a cot a plus cosecant square. So from this to, let me consider this is two, this is one term and this is one full term. We can take it as outside a cot a plus cosecant a. Cot a plus cosecant a, we will be getting this as a 1 plus this as a 1 into cot a minus cosecant a. I think denominator we got as an cot a minus cosecant a is there, we need a 1, right? So here let me keep it as a 1, so cosecant square a minus cot square a is a 1. So that we changed here actually, but I hope we don't need to change, without changing itself we are getting a cancel. So we don't need to change at the numerator, but the beginning it's difficult to understand, but by the step also we can do. So the both get cancelled and we got it as an cot a plus cosecant a. So I hope we got it, right? This is what we need. So it's given questions and they said to use the identities cosecant a and cot a. So we divided with this sine a so that we will be changing entire in terms of an cosec and cot. So here we get entire term into cosec and cot. So instead of this 1, we are substituting the identities cosecant square a minus cot square a. And later, by simplifying everything, we came to know that numerator and denominator cancelled and got a plus cos v k, so which is equal to RHS, right? So hence, proof. And here we go for the next problem. Square root of 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a is equal to ck plus tan. So here is the sin, the entire term and change to sec and tan. So okay, first we choose the LHS, that's square root of 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a. So we have to, first you have to cancel the square root, right? So by taking the conjugate, the numerator will become the whole square. So we get cancelled, right? By changing the conjugate means in multiplied with denominator that we are changing the sign. 1 plus sin a. So by taking this conjugate, you can see the numerator become the whole square. So square root can be cancelled and denominator also will change by the identities. Look at see. So it will become 1 plus sin a into 1 plus sin a. It is a 1 plus sin a the whole square divided by here 1 minus sin a and 1 plus sin a. It is like an a minus b into a plus b form, right? So 1 square minus sin square a. It is a square root, right? So now the square root and then numerator square and will be cancelled. So numerator will be getting a 1 plus sin a. And the denominator, there is a square root of 1 square, is a 1 minus sin square a. We know that 1 minus sin square is a cos square a, right? By the identities. So 1 plus sin a divided by square root of cos square a. So here also the square and square root get cancelled, right? So 1 plus sin a divided by cos a. So we are almost that. We need a ck plus tan a, right? Just by taking a division for this each term in the numerator, we will be getting. So 1 by cos a plus sin a divided by cos a. So 1 by cos a, we can say it as an ck by ratios plus sin a by cos a, it is a tan a. So which is an RHS we require. So we have proved. So here we go for the next problem. So LHS given is sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta by 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta is equal to tan theta. So entire term is get changed in the LHS, right? So no problem. So you can see here cube is there and here is only sin theta. Yes, the same the denominator. Cos cube is there, only cos theta is there. We can take the common outside. So sin theta into 1 minus 2 cube, the 1 center is taken. So square is that 2 sin square theta divided by. So here is also the same cos, we can take it out and we will be getting in a 2 cos square theta. Here the cube, 1 cos we have taken out and here is also we have took out. So it will be a 1. So now we know that sin theta by cos theta is the tan theta. So we obtain the tan theta. Only thing we have to change, that means we have to cancel this numerator and denominator, but it's totally different. Here is a sin square and here is a cos square, but that is possible to change by applying this. Instead of this 1, we can write as an sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So 1 we can write in the sin square theta plus cos square theta, right? So with the help of this, the both will be become equal and we can cancel. See, so instead of 1 I am writing as an sin square theta plus cos square theta minus 2 sin square theta divided by here cos theta into 2 cos square theta minus, instead of 1 I am writing a sin square theta minus cos square theta plus cos theta. So minus is there, so entire will sin will changes. So minus sin square theta minus cos square theta. Since here is a minus, so both will get a minus, right? So by simplifying that we will be getting, so sin square theta minus 2 sin square theta we will be getting in a minus sin theta, right? Minus sin square theta and plus cos square theta will be as it is, right? This sin square theta we have subtracted the minus 2 sin square theta and denominator cos theta is that, and 2 cos square theta is subtracted with the minus sin cos square theta. 2 minus 1 is 1, the positive, so cos square theta minus sin square theta. So both numerator and denominator are same, right? We cancelled. So minus sin square theta plus cos theta, here cos square theta minus sin square theta. Only the order have changed. So not a problem. So both cancelled. So it's a sin theta by cos theta, which is equal to tan which is equal to sine theta by cos theta we got, and which is equal to tan theta, so which is an RHS, and hence we have proved.